The U.S. Navy has commissioned USS Jack H. Lucas, DDG 125, its first Flight 3 variant Arleigh Burke-class destroyer, in Tampa, Florida. U.S. Navy Undersecretary Erik Raven led the ship's commissioning ceremony, stressing the importance of DDG 125's role in the U.S.'s push for advanced defense protocols. He said commissioning the Jack H. Lucas means we continue to deliver fast, agile, and networked surface combatants to the Navy. The Jack H. Lucas is built to fight. It's a fast, maneuverable, versatile, and lethal ship, capable of tackling any mission it's given. He added, it will keep the Navy and Marine Corps adaptive and ready, and also uphold our commitment to maintaining the free flow of commerce, deterring military aggression, and facilitating quick responses to natural disasters across the globe. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what makes the USS Jack H. Lucas the most lethal destroyer in the U.S. Navy. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The class is named for Admiral Arleigh Burke, an American destroyer officer in World War II and later Chief of Naval Operations. Arleigh Burke-class warships are designed to be capable of performing multiple missions. These can carry out anti-aircraft warfare, AAW, anti-submarine warfare, ASW, anti-surface warfare, ASUW. Viewers may note that Flight 3 is the fourth flight upgrade in the 30-plus-year history of the class and is preceded by Flight 1, 2, and 2A. The guided missile destroyer incorporates upgraded electrical power and cooling systems, but the main enhancement is the addition of ANSPY 6V1 air and missile defense radar, the Navy's next-generation radar system. The destroyer is also fitted with Lockheed Martin's upgraded AEGIS weapon system Baseline 10 software, which controls all of the ship's weapons suite and enable much better operational readiness. The ANSPY 6 is an active electronically scanned array 3D radar developed for the United States Navy, USN. It's designed to provide integrated air and missile defense for Flight 3 Arleigh Burke-class destroyers. Variants are also developed for retrofitting Flight 2A Arleigh Burkes and for installation aboard Constellation-class frigates, Gerald R. Ford-class aircraft carriers, and San Antonio-class amphibious transport docks. The SPY-6 radars, integrated to the Aegis combat system, can help defend against ballistic missiles, cruise missiles, hostile aircraft, and surface ships simultaneously, and provide several advantages over legacy radars, including greater detection range, increased sensitivity, and more accurate discrimination. It will enable Arleigh Burke warships to shoot down incoming threats by using missiles like SM-6 more reliably. SPY-6 has scalable and modular radar arrays that reduce cost and sustainment needs while meeting the mission requirements of 7 classes of ships. The U.S. Navy has secured contracts from Raytheon for the SPY-6 radar half a decade ago, receiving contracts as far back as 2018. The SPY-6 system consists of 2 primary radars and a radar suite controller, RSC, to coordinate the sensors. An S-band radar is to provide volume search, tracking, ballistic missile defense discrimination, and missile communications, while the X-band radar is to provide horizon search, precision tracking, missile communication, and terminal illumination of targets. The S-band and X-band sensors will also share functionality, including radar navigation, periscope detection, and missile guidance and communication. SPY-6 is intended as a scalable system, with each sensor array assembled from radar modular assemblies (RMA), self-contained radar modules. The transmit-receive modules use new gallium nitride (GaN) semiconductor technology, allowing for a higher power density than the previous gallium arsenide radar modules. The new radar will require twice the electrical power as the previous generation, while generating over 35 times as much radar power. The SPY-6 was not originally designed to perform electronic attacks, but it may have the capability to do so using its AESA antenna. The contract will see two variants being integrated into Arleigh Burke-class destroyers. One, and SPY-6V-1, also known as the Air and Missile Defense Radar, or AMDR. This is a four-sided phased array radar, each with 37 RMAs. It's estimated to have a 15 decibel sensitivity improvement compared to the previous generation ANSPY-1 radar, or capable of detecting targets half the size at twice the distance. It's meant for Flight 3 Arleigh Burke destroyers. 2. ANSPY-6V-4, a four-sided phased array radar with 24 RMAs. It's designed to be retrofitted to Flight 2A Arleigh Burke destroyers. Aegis Weapon System Baseline 10 software is based on a new architecture. Lockheed Martin states that this will increase the speed at which new upgrades can be made to the system. Lockheed aims to leverage this innovative architecture to significantly reduce the usual timeline for delivering a new capability to the fleet. It will work with the Common Source Library, CSL, that will combine all surface Navy capabilities into a single software repository. Baseline 10 is anticipated to enable the team to incorporate new capabilities into the library within 3 to 4 weeks, rather than the extended period of 3 to 4 months in some instances. The company reports that it's been increasingly automating tests to expedite the verification of software updates, referring to Baseline 10 as the most comprehensive evolution of an Aegis baseline to date. USS Jack H. Lucas has a very extensive weapons package. The warship has, in total, 96 Mark 41 Vertical Launch System (VLS), divided into two blocks of 32 and 64 cells. These are capable of launching a variety of missiles, including Tomahawk, Standard Missiles 2, 3, and 6, ESSM Blocks 1 and 2, as well as RUM-139A VL ASROC. It's equipped with an upgraded 5-inch diameter gun for surface warfare and land attack, a 20mm Phalanx Close-In Weapon System (CIWS), two 25mm Mark 38 machine gun systems, and four 50 caliber 12.7mm guns. It also has two Mark 141 Harpoon missile launchers for the anti-ship role. Two Mark 32 triple torpedo tubes are available for launching Mark 46 or Mark 50 torpedoes. ANSPY-6V-1, along with Aegis Baseline 10 combat system, is a potent combination. With the ANSPY-6V-1, USS Jack H. Lucas will see much farther and also be able to guide its wide array of weapons much more accurately. This makes the warship the most lethal destroyer in the U.S. Navy.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.